Defense Updates has reached 200,000 subscribers. We cannot thank you enough. We promise to keep delivering interesting content.
Follow us on social media. Support us on Patreon. All links in description below.
America's Sea Hunter has taken a major step forward. On January 30th, the U.S. Navy accepted the Anti-Submarine Warfare Continuous Trail Unmanned Vessel, ACTUV, from DARPA, the Pentagon's premier technology innovation agency. The Sea Hunter, as the first ship of the ACTUV program is called, is an unmanned ship primarily designed to track quiet diesel-electric submarines for months with little or no human help. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how America plans to tackle Russia and Chinese submarines with unmanned Sea Hunter craft.
Number 5.
Improving America's ASW, or anti-submarine warfare, capability is a pressing need, given the proliferation in the number and sophistication of enemy submarines. China's a major worry in this regard. According to some estimates, Beijing's diesel-electric submarine fleet could grow from roughly 50 in 2016 to 75 in 2030. These sheer numbers don't tell the whole story because Chinese submarines will also grow more advanced and quieter as Beijing retires aging vessels in favor of more modern ones. Russia is also making numerous advances in its undersea fleet since 2000 after allowing its capabilities to decline following the Cold War. Last year, a Russian Kilo-class diesel submarine, Krasnodar, had shocked the world. The submarine was able to move from Libya to Syria, a distance of more than 2,000 kilometers, undetected, even with significant number of NATO assets trying to track it. To know more, check the video on the above card. The Russians are also building two other new designs. Both are nuclear-powered. The Bore-class are Russia's new generation of ballistic missile submarines, the cornerstone and most survivable part of its nuclear arsenal. The Hunter class, called the ASIN, is intended to destroy U.S. aircraft carriers. And the Wall Street Journal speculates one of these, the Kazan, may have secretly shadowed the USS George H.W. Bush and Britain's newest aircraft carrier, HMS Queen Elizabeth, during August exercises in the North Atlantic. This all adds up to present a major step back towards the level of submarine activity that was a feature of the Cold War.
Number 4.
DARPA has described the objective of the program as developing an advanced unmanned maritime system autonomy to enable independently deploying systems capable of missions spanning thousands of kilometers of range and months of endurance under a sparse remote supervisory control model. This included demonstrating the ship's ability to follow all international maritime laws and the capability of the ACTUV system to use its unique characteristics to employ non-conventional sensor technologies that achieve robust continuous track of the quietest submarine targets over their entire operating envelope. DARPA also noted that while the immediate goal was to improve anti-submarine warfare tracking capabilities, the core platform and autonomy technologies are broadly extendable to underpin a wide range of missions and configurations for future unmanned naval vessels. One particular interesting prospect is using the Sea Hunter and future ships to conduct mine-clearing missions, which wouldn't require putting sailors' lives at risk. According to DARPA, the prototype vessel completed tests using a mine countermeasure MCM payload in August of 2017.
Number 3.
One DARPA official who worked on the ACTUV program noted that the ship represents something of a shift in philosophy for the U.S. Navy. ACTUV represents a new vision of naval surface warfare that trades small numbers of very capable, high-value assets for large numbers of commoditized, simpler platforms that are more capable in the aggregate. Fred Kennedy, the director of DARPA's Tactical Technology Office, said, "The U.S. military has talked about the strategic importance of replacing king and queen pieces on the maritime chessboard with lots of pawns, and ACTUV is a first step toward doing exactly that. The Sea Hunter will approximately cost $15,000 to $20,000 per day to operate, whereas the average cost of operating a guided missile destroyer with anti-submarine warfare capabilities are around $700,000 per day.
Number 2.
The resulting prototype of this is a 140-ton ship that's 132 feet long, making it the largest unmanned ship ever built. The ship can reportedly also reach speeds of 27 knots. Further work on ACTUV, including building new ships, will be handled by the Office of Naval Research, ONR, which became a partner on the program in 2014. DARPA itself began work on the program around 2010. Joint testing began in 2016. ONR will continue developing the revolutionary prototype vehicle, the first of what could ultimately become an entirely new class of ocean-going vessel, able to traverse thousands of kilometers over open seas for months at a time without a single crew member aboard, as the Medium Displacement Unmanned Surface Vehicle, MDUSV, DARPA said in a statement announcing the transfer. The U.S. Navy could induct the first Sea Hunter into service as early as this year.
Number 1.
Sea Hunter is built by Oregon Iron Works, now called Vigor Works, a firm that specializes in exotic, experimental, and stealthy watercraft. Leidos, which manufactured the first vessel's navigation system, has since taken over the project entirely. In December 2017, that company received a $35.5 million contract from the Navy to build the second hull, referred to as Sea Hunter 2. The bulk of that work would occur at a shipyard in Gulfport, Mississippi. The deal also included an unspecified number of option periods that could raise its total value to more than $43.5 million for continued work through 2020.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.